I thought we'd have a little fun and take a look at a very specific aspect of the PowKitty Q90. Not the system as a whole, but specifically this little stick. Everybody who's touched a Q90 will tell you that this little stick is absolutely useless. I gotta agree. I think it's only there so that the outward appearance can look like on other handhelds on the market. There were a couple on the market that were built like this that had analog sticks there. And I think that's what this is. Remember that this device only goes up to just below PS1. Even Super Nintendo is a little shaky. So there aren't a whole lot of games that actually have analog input. You could find a handful of games for MAME that probably do. For example, old games that required a steering wheel. Spy Hunter in the arcade had a steering wheel. Super Sprint had one. Things like that. But I don't have those hooked up. So what I have is a couple of games here that I want to try and see if I can find any value. Specifically, the first thing that came to mind was belt racing games like that. And I can't think of a better term for them. But Outrun is a perfect game. I don't have that set up here. So I thought Rad Racer would be another game like that. I don't have that set up here. So I thought, okay, what do I have where I can actually try this thing? And I think Bump and Jump appears on this list. Yeah, here we go. So let's try it with Bump and Jump. Oop, hang on. I think I might have my NES emulator messed up. Hang on. Yeah, here we go. Man, it's been a while. So as you can imagine, oh, that's right, I have to press up, isn't that it? Is it up? No. Here we go. So the strength would be in that it takes more. It is up. Oop. It takes more effort to make the to make it go left or right. Uh-oh. Hit the iron. So some of these racing games where you know, you want to have a little bit more of a precision arrow input. I could see it being an okay novelty there. Except I'm sucking this game up. Here we go. Let's try one I'm familiar with. That's right. I immediately went to the. Yeah, it does feel a little bit more like a steering wheel, I guess, when I use it. It's very awkward. But I guess you could get used to anything if you use it enough. It's just funny because these devices are set up so that you can use them on a large array of games. And you have this stick, and it's like, what? There's so little that this stick would be good for. It doesn't make sense to like, I don't know. They could have used the extra space to make like another system button or something. I don't know. Seems like a weird choice. I gotta say. If you're piloting a vehicle, it's not too bad. All right, let's try something else where I'm not driving a car. Shoot, I lost it. Yeah, here we go. I don't know why this was the game, but when I tested it in my private time, this was the game that I used. It's the antithesis of anything this like should be useful for. But I actually ended up kind of enjoying it. But the thing that's weird, I mean, it's painfully apparent that as a standard feature, there's no point for it. The only reason I have fun with it is because it's a novelty. And it's as difficult as it is to play with a stick. It's even harder to play hunched in front of my phone like this. I guess that's a punch. Yes! Durabka would be so mad at me when he sees how bad I'm doing in Altered Beast. No! There we go. I want the thing! Isn't there a way to jump in this game? I think I had the same issue last time I played it. I played Altered Beast more on the Master System than any other, than this. Which is weird, because I know, like, it's not everybody's favorite Genesis game as it is, and if you go to the Master System, it's even more primitive. But yeah, that's the stick. It's weird. I wouldn't recommend it, but I don't know. If you have one of these things around, it's an interesting challenge. Do I recommend this device? Not at all.